Hey guys, Toby Mathis here, and today we're going to dive into the difference between Roth IRAs and a traditional IRA from a math standpoint so you can get the best benefit. Are you getting the most out of your retirement? Well, it takes a working knowledge of the numbers to really get that benefit. So let's dive in to the major differences from a math standpoint between a traditional IRA and a Roth IRA. Let's go over what they are first. Number one, a traditional IRA is an individual retirement arrangement where the IRS gives you a tax deduction for putting money in. There are some income limitations as to whether you get that tax deduction, and it depends on whether you have another plan at work, another job, 401k, things like that, and how much you make as to whether you actually get the tax benefit. But if you do just normal person and you're investing, you're making an average amount of money according to the census, you're going to get to do a traditional IRA where you could put this year $7,000 into that plan and write it off. If you are a little bit older, you get an extra $1,000. And if you have a company plan, you could actually be using a 401k, which you could be writing off up to $10,000. But for the sake of my purposes, I'm just going to use some flat numbers to show you the difference in how it works from a tax standpoint. Now, let's say that you are not interested in the tax deduction, but you want tax deferral and to never pay tax again on any of the growth in a retirement account. You just described a Roth IRA, where you could put $7,000 a year into a Roth, where you don't get a tax deduction, but you never have to pay tax ever again on any of its growth and any of the money that comes out of that Roth. So they're absolutely effective. Now, which one is better? I always hear about this. I have folks that are making big money and they'll do a conversion. They'll take a traditional retirement account, either an IRA, 401k, or a deferred account, and they convert it to a Roth and they pay the tax at their ordinary rate that year that they do that conversion. And I see them doing this over and over again. And quite often it's after the fact and I go, ooh, I wouldn't have done that. You're in the highest tax bracket. You just got hit with a 37% tax plus your state to put it into this environment. You don't understand the math. And they always point and say, well, Peter Thiel made $5 billion in his Roth. There, it must be great. Let me show you the math. They are identical from a mathematical standpoint. What matters is your tax bracket higher now versus what it'll be in the future? Or is it lower now than it will be in the future? If it's higher now than it will be in the future, you want to do a traditional plan. If it's lower now, you'll want to do a Roth. That's how the numbers work. And let me show you. So let's just say, I'm going to say for sake of argument, I'm going to use $10,000. And I know that the limit is seven right now, but I'm just going to, for sake of doing math in my head, let's just say we have $10,000. And by the way, this would be doable in a 401k. So it's the same scenario. I could deduct $10,000 a year. I could deduct considerably more than $10,000 a year. Let's say that I have the traditional side and we have the Roth side. I'm just going to map these out so you can kind of see it. I'm just going to go zoom, put a line right through it. So if I put $10,000 into my traditional, I will have $10,000 sitting there to invest. If I did the exact same thing, but did it as a Roth, I do not get a tax deduction. So I'm going to owe tax. So I'm just going to use 25% as my basis. That's going to be the tax percentage. And we're going to use that on both sides. We're going to use that for when the money comes out and when the money goes in. So I have $7,500 then that I was able to put into my Roth because I had to pay the tax. And I know some of you guys are like, no, I put the whole $10,000. Well, where did you get the money to pay the tax, right? I'm saying if we put all of our money in here and there's not extra to invest, then we would only be able to put $7,500 because we have a tax bill. If you want to play the other game, then I'm going to say, well, the tax savings, $10,000 saved me $2,500. I would have $12,500 if this was $10,000. But the math is going to work out the same no matter what. And I'll show you how it works. If you use the rule of 72, which is for compounding, It means that an account will double. You take the interest rate that it's earning, divide it into 72, and that's how many years it will take to double. So the S&P's returned over 10%. So it's going to be about every 7 years. So we take 72 divided by 10 point whatever it is. I'm just going to use, for sake of argument, our money is going to double every 7 years. So let's just say we take this and we say seven. This is going to be 20,000. This is going to be $15,000 after 7 years. We do another 7 years and we go, let's say we're 14 years out. Now we're at 40,000 in the traditional versus 30,000 down here. We go another 7 years. So now we're 21 years down the road. We now have 80,000 in the traditional. They're compounding tax-free. So it literally would be doubling about like this. And we have 60,000. And it's time to retire. Let's say that for whatever reason, we're at our retirement age and we decide to take the money out. All things being equal, by the way, this is still continuing to compound, but let's just say we took the money out and we were over 59 and a half. We just took the money out and we paid 25%. We would have $60,000 left, right? Can we all agree that 25% off of 80 would be 20,000 bucks, right? So 75% of that would be $60,000. So how about the Roth? Well, we don't have to take anything out. $60,000 would have zero tax. What's left? You guessed it. It's still $60,000. Our $60,000 is what we have regardless at the end of the day. That's why I say they're identical. Where the money, where it would start to adjust is, let's say that you had no tax. Let's say that I was super young and I was able to put $10,000 aside. It was the first $10,000 I made and I deferred it all into a 401k. So just for sake of argument. And you had zero tax there and then you had 25% tax at the end. We would see this be the $10,000 and you'd have Same factor. We'd have 20K, you'd have 40K, you'd have 80K, and you would have 80,000 here. You'd still be the same numbers on the top line for the traditional. You're not getting any tax benefit, so you know you wouldn't do that, right? Most people, when they're in that 0%, you're going to be better off doing the Roth, or if you're in 10%. 15%. Anything below, I would say 22%, you're probably going to make sense to put it into that Roth. Because at the end of the day, whatever you're going to take out, chances are you're going to be in a tax bracket that might be slightly higher. Now, I will say this, being a person, a tax attorney that likes averages, statistically, the amount that you're paying when you retire, the percentage that you're paying for your taxes goes down when you retire. It's not the same as when you're in your prime years, for sure. It actually goes down. It's in the teens. So the amount that you actually pay goes down. So if you're in a higher tax bracket, so we'll do the opposite and we'll say instead of zero, let's say that you're in 37, then these numbers get blown out, right? The tax benefit is so huge, you're crazy not to do a traditional. And especially if this number is not going to be, let's say it's on average 15%, you're at 37 versus 15, you're gonna be much better off putting your money into that traditional. Let's kind of run those numbers. Let's say it's 37%, we'd be at 6,400, which is 12.8, which is, let's see if I could do the math, 14, 20, what is that, 25.6, and then what is that, 51.2, so 51,000 when it comes out, versus if I put that, I'd still have the 80,000 and whatever tax I had to pay, if it was at 15%, would be considerably less. What is that, about 12,000? So I'd be at 68,000 versus 51,000. It's just math, like playing with the math, right? So if you're somebody who's in the higher tax brackets, you definitely want to go traditional retirement accounts. If you're somebody in a lower tax bracket, you're in the 10, 12%, you're going to want to do that Roth. And that's what the numbers tell us. I'm a numbers guy. If you know anybody that's contemplating doing that conversion, share this with them. If you have a preference, put it down below. Do you like Roths or do you like traditional IRAs? And why? Put that in the comments. I always like getting some feedback. And if you want me to address a specific topic that you think that I should be addressing in my YouTube channel, please put it down below. I actually get ideas from y'all as well. And if you could do me a huge favor and like and subscribe. Thanks, guys.